Have you ever wondered if a wind turbine will still work when it gets cold? You and I have an insatiable appetite for electricity. Come with me and we'll look at the issues relative to wind farms and the communities that they serve. This is the Windfarm Guy. Hi, this is Dennis Stout, and thank you for joining me for this episode of the Windfarm Guy. The question is asked, can wind turbines operate when it gets cold? Well, the short answer is yes, of course. It's a piece of machinery and they can operate when it gets cold. Not every wind turbine is installed in a nice balmy southern state in the U.S. They're also installed in cold areas. In fact, probably more wind turbines are installed in places where it's typical to experience some kind of cold weather. You have to keep in mind, the wind industry began in Europe and it gets cold there. And when you consider the number of turbines that are installed in Northern Europe and in the North Sea, wind turbine manufacturers are well versed in dealing with cold weather. You move across the ocean to here to the United States and you know you encounter the same thing. Sure, you have the southern tier states where things are really nice and you don't deal with a whole lot of cold weather. But as you move further north to the Dakotas or Wyoming or Iowa or wherever, you get into snow and ice and colder climates. And yes, the wind turbines do operate in that environment. Wind turbines have cooling systems that help them keep them from overheating in the hot summer months, but they also are very well maintained so that they can endure the cold winter months. But one of the biggest concerns is ice buildup. You have to remember that a wind turbine, a wind blade, is pretty much like an airplane wing. An airplane wing is an airfoil, and when there's ice buildup on an airplane wing, two things happen. One, the shape of the airfoil changes and it no longer gets the lift that it used to get, and then it also weighs more. And both of those things combined make the wing much less efficient and even dangerous for the people on board the airplane. A wind turbine, the blade on a wind turbine is much the same. As ice builds up on that blade, first thing is it changes the shape of it so it becomes less efficient. It's not generating as much electricity, but it also adds weight to the rotor, and as it's turning, it's turning more, it has more weight that it has to move, more mass, and it becomes less and less efficient. So wind farm companies don't like ice buildup because it makes the turbines not as efficient, not generate as much electricity. Add to that the possibility of the ice falling off. When the ice builds up on the blades, it's at some point it's going to fall off. It's going to melt and it either drip, but as you see around your house and whatever, sometimes chunks will fall off. And it doesn't matter whether those chunks fall straight down or as it's turning, if it tosses it a ways, it's kind of a dangerous thing. It's a serious thing either way. My recommendation to you is when it's icing, when it's cold, freezing weather, stay away from a wind turbine. I am not next to one of these wind turbines. I'm a long way away, and you should do the same thing. Stay away from them because the ice that is built up on those blades is going to come off, and you don't want to be anywhere near that because it could be harmful to people or animals or structures. It can cause serious damage. That is why many areas and all wind farms will have setbacks from roads and homes and stuff, and sometimes the counties have they impose these setbacks, and it's all about safety, keeping people safe from ice falling off of a wind turbine. But an interesting thing, the airfoil of a wing of an airplane and the airfoil on the blade of a turbine are so similar that as technology advances in one or the other where they're dealing with the ice buildup, as one discovers new ways of dealing with it, the other industry is sure to at least consider and apply those principles if they can. Yes, wind turbines can operate during cold weather. But you know what? cars can operate during cold weather as well. And when you're driving a car in icing, freezing weather, what do? You slow down, you exercise greater caution, you allow a little more space, distance. The same thing is true for wind turbines. You should exercise more caution. The ice is there, it's going to fall off. Exercise the caution and stay away, stay a distance until everything thaws so that there's no danger any longer. This is Dennis Stout, and I'm the Wind Farm Guy. Thank you for watching. Working together, we can make good energy decisions and save our planet. I am the Windfarm Guy.